Hello YouTube, it's Andy again, and today we are going to review a very inexpensive fragrance. And most of you must have heard of this fragrance, I'm sure, if you've been in the fragrance game long enough. Today we are going to review a fragrance from the house of Jacques Bogart called One Man Show. It's a very common fragrance, and if you haven't heard of this house, let me tell you one thing. Jacques Bogart creates some excellent quality fragrance which are very cheap. And they are very cheap because Jacques Bogart is not a big name in the designer fragrance game. That's the only reason that they are cheap. But, and you'll be surprised, I paid $11.99 Canadian dollars for this 100 ml bottle of One Man Show. And the price does not justify the fragrance. This is a beautiful fragrance for the price that I paid. So if you're on a tight budget and you want to smell great, then it's an excellent option to go for Jacques Bogart fragrances. One Man Show, Silver Scent, there are some excellent options if you can lay your hands on them. Now, let me show you the box. This is the box. If you can see, it's a grey colored box with golden lines going all around it. When you open the box and take out the bottle, this is a bottle, fairly simple presentation. The juice is green, and the color of the juice is exactly what the fragrance smells like. It's a green fragrance. One more thing, if you pay close attention, you can see that there's a Jacques Bogart logo. This is their logo, which is there, mentioned on the cap. The cap is not to be taken out. It serves as the sprayer as well. Now, this fragrance was released in the year 1980. The perfumer behind this fragrance is Roger Pellegrino. Top notes: Basil, Bergamot, Caraway, Galbanum, Artemisia and Brazilian Rosewood. Heart notes: Pine tree needles, Carnation, Nutmeg, Patchouli, Spices, Vetiver, Geranium, Labdanum, Rose and Jasmine. Base notes: Oakmoss, Leather, Cedar, Sandalwood, Styrax, Amber, Tonka Bean, Coconut, Vanilla and Castoreum. The company which markets this fragrance is Parfums Jacques Bogart. This company was founded in 1975. It's Jacques Bogart, as the name says, it's a French designer. This fragrance house was founded in 1975. It was a cosmetics and skincare company. It has 157 own name stores and is an independent family business. There are 9 cosmetics or fragrance brands that the company owns or produces. Some notable brands that the company manages are Bogart, Stendhal, Ted Lapidus, Faconnable, and Jeanne Piaubert. Now, this fragrance is a mature fragrance. This fragrance is a very formal scent. It's not at all a casual scent, and this is a mature scent. So, to appreciate this fragrance, you need to be 35 years and above. Below 35 years, if you are below 35 years, you can't really appreciate the fragrance. The prominent notes from this fragrance are galbanum, pine tree. That pine tree accord is very strong in this fragrance. The pine accord lasts from the beginning to the end. It's the dominant note of this fragrance. And then you get oak moss and leather and cedar. Oak moss, leather and cedar. They are also present throughout the age of the fragrance. It has similarities to Drakkar Noir as well. It's probably because of the pine note in it. Now, this is an out and out winter scent. If you try it in high heat, it will stifle you. So don't even try it. It's an out and out winter scent. You can wear it in fall as well, and probably in the evenings. I've even worn this fragrance in winters to my office, and it has that warming sensation. It keeps you warm and cozy, and that's probably because of pine and tobacco being present in this fragrance. And $11.99 Canadians, 100 ml bottle. It's an excellent value fragrance for that that amount of price. You know, when you pay $11.99 for a 100 ml bottle, you think, oh, this would just be garbage. But this is not garbage. This is good quality for the price that you pay. This is excellent bang for your buck. And in winters, this fragrance lasts for 8 to 10 hours on my skin. I go to my office 8 hours a day. When I come home, even then I can smell it. So that's excellent performance for this fragrance. And it's very masculine because it has pine, it has tobacco. So it's a very masculine fragrance. Yes, it, from today's perspective, it was released in 1980. We are in 2021. So it might smell a little dated to some people, but it's still an excellent fragrance. This, my dear friends, is an ad for this fragrance. And as you can see, the model in the ad, he's in a suit, a well-groomed gentleman. So this is not a casual fragrance. This is for office wear or for when you are properly dressed up. It's not a fragrance for when you are in a t-shirt. It's a fragrance when you are in a formal shirt and suit, in an official attire. And these are the options available for this fragrance. As you can see, there's a 100 ml bottle. Then there's a 100 ml bottle with a small tube, white tube of aftershave. I even have this aftershave with me, and it's excellent for winters. I've tried the aftershave with the fragrance, and when you try it with the aftershave, it lasts for 12 to 14 hours. And then there's a gift pack with a soap and the fragrance, and even that is wonderful. This fragrance, if you compare it to similar fragrances in its price range, it reminds me of Anthony Puig's Corum. Very similar to Corum. Probably the pine and tobacco note which ties the two together. Then it also has a similar vibe to Versace L'Homme. Versace L'Homme, as you know, that's also a very old fragrance. And again, the same notes tie them together, the tobacco and the pine accord. And then Crisia Umo is also very similar to this. I forgot to put one fragrance here, which I already mentioned, Drakkar Noyar. You'll get the same vibe as Drakkar Noyar as well from Guy Laroche. And that is also because of the pine and tobacco note. Pine and tobacco was a very common note in the fragrances from yesteryears. And it was used very well in fragrances which were meant for winters. And that's why this is a true winter scent, a formal winter scent. So guys, if you can lay your hand on One Man Show by Jacques Bogart, it would be an excellent scent in your collection for the cooler months, for the winter months. And don't go by the price. Don't think just because you're paying $11, $15 for this gift set or a bottle, it's garbage. It's not garbage. Try it in the winter, especially in the winter. I'm reiterating this again. I'm stressing this fact. Try it in winters. That is when this fragrance truly shines. It's a warm, cozy fragrance in the winter months. And you won't be disappointed by its performance. Hey YouTube, this is my daughter. Her name is Natanya. Natanya, say hi to YouTube.
Hi.
So Natanya would also like to share something about this fragrance. Natanya, you're wearing this fragrance on your hand. What do you have to say about it?
It's very good.
It's good? You like it?
Yeah.
Okay. And Natanya also has her own channel. You can please subscribe to NOYA, Noya channel. Okay YouTube, thank you so much for watching this video, and please I want to bring more and more unknown fragrances, inexpensive fragrances which are good to your notice, so that we all can enjoy fragrances. So if you do like this content, then please do like and subscribe. Thank you so much, guys. Shalom.